Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Good afternoon, everyone, and youngster of our country, Pakistan. Welcome to all of you here in this auditorium. There is a session of women empowerment. Before sharing my views about the topic, first of all, I will introduce myself. And the topic which I have selected that is related with one organization. When I was a student in my childhood, in 9th class, 6th class, 5th class, why I am coming from up to down? Because I was eager to speak before the audience and let the people realize that you have to speak. So at that time, I was very interested to just speak before the audience and let the people see that you can speak. It was my aim. And Alhamdulillah, I achieved that aim. I was the best debater during my university levels. I studied on a scholarship from the honor of the Channel 5 Chief Ziya Shahid. I qualified in scholarship and I completed my education from there. Thrice time I appeared in CSS, but I could not qualify. Once time I qualified CSS, but I could not get the post due to allocation. I had experience of CSS, I have experience of PCS, I have experience of living in society where there is a low literacy rate. I have seen the people who are highly educated, but they never ever give time to other people. In Pakistan, where 40 to 45% of the population, they are living below poverty line. We claim that we are educated, really we are not educated. So I thought that I have to work, I have an experience about my life. Today I am failed, but tomorrow you people never ever fail. So for that, in July 2018, I found one social organization that is named as KTU. KTU stands for Khairpur Organization. My aim in life to be the speaker, but really I was the good educator. At that time even I tried, but I could not get it. Because you know that in Khairpur, even in interior scene, there is no opportunity to show my talent, even you people. So I could not be the best cricketer, I could not play for Pakistan at international level. So I thought that I have to make an organization that should be to represent the talent of Khairpur, that is the KTU, Khairpur Talent Organization. Means you people are the having talent. You can do everything in this world as other people who are living in Pakistan and rest of the world. I just to wake up you that you have a talent, show your talent to come up and fight for Pakistan, represent Pakistan at international level. Alhamdulillah, I am not a doctor, but on Hepatitis Day, I conducted one seminar, Hepatitis Day, got in such a library. I just tested that Panoplex page posted over there that we want to celebrate, we want to give awareness on this Hepatitis Day to the people. From different cities, some students, parents, they came over there and attended a seminar. The main purpose of this celebration was to just create awareness. And from United Kingdom, I received invitation. They considered and me that, Dr. Khalid, we are very happy that you have arranged a seminar on Hepatitis Day. So we invite you to come UK. I gave them reply that I am not a doctor, but if you are not a doctor, then why you conducted their seminar? I said that I am a doctor who cannot just stand sit in the office in the hospital, but I am the wild walking doctor. So everyone is a wild walking doctor. They appreciated me. And for that, if I am not doctor, then I send one project, that is on the diabetes. You know that, Alhamdulillah, here you are a doctor. I don't need to go into it. You can easily understand it. This dry fruit contains the huge amount of kilocalories. Even it is mentioned in the Holy Quran that a sugar patient, it is the shifa for all. It is give one project that we should extract sugar from dates. Dry dates. In the seminar that is scheduled in Switzerland, 23rd and 4th May 2019. I will go over there and I will represent to all of you, all Pakistanis, dates in Khairpur, where are the millions of dates, date palms. But there is no any sugar factory that we may extract sugar from dates. So inshallah ta'ala, I will go over there and represent. This is the mega project. This is the big project. Inshallah ta'ala, I will go over there and to show my talents. The main purpose of this organization is just to conduct seminars, to arrange seminars, to conduct workshops. Besides that, to care counseling, to guide you. That I am failed, you never ever be failed. This is the main agenda of this social organization. It is your organization. It is your talent organization. Come and show your talent. Whatever, if you are doctor, if you are engineer, if you are expert teacher, whatsoever you are living in Khairpur, you have to show your talent. So regarding this, Alhamdulillah, we have conducted many seminars on the platform of Khairpur Talent Organization to show the talents. That if I can give name that Pakistan Talent Organization, no, we are living in a small village. Khairpur is not a big city, but we can consider it. But why we are deprived of from all equal rights? We should be from Khairpur. There are one man. Maybe there are many students. They can be selected for cricket. They can be selected for another post. Even in Khairpur, there are many highly educated women. From your side, there one should be the Minister of Health from UP, means doctor. So like this, then we have to work here. So I will give explanation about the topic. Khairpur Talent Organization has conducted one seminar, that is Women Empowerment. In this program, you have to ask the question which are related with this topic. Because you know that when China came into being in 1949, at that time they never ever knew the other language. We can say that mostly you have seen them, they are speaking Chinese language. So they thought that we have to invite the scholars, educated people. They invited over there, but you know that he was a great philosopher. He went over there to conduct the seminar. Now, from our youngsters, they are going over there. Means now China has developed. They are offering scholarships. But still, we are not able to even give education to our youngsters. And we have just deprived the girls. Where there is an equal number. We can say that girls can be more than the men. So this is the reason that why they are big. So you have asked the question. The main purpose of conducting seminar just create awareness, and the day will come that we will realize the importance of girls' education. You have a very experience about the status of women that they have in Pakistan. So have a look at last year, but in Pakistan, why there is a gender? We can say even that women was created from men's rib. It is our part. We cannot be separated. Then why we have sent them back and here go? We have just bound them in home. You stay over here. This is your paradise. But this is not. Let them free. Give them education. Then they can do good for you. The best way to predict the nature is to create it. There is one great saying, give me educated mother, I will give you educated nation. We cannot claim that we are an educated nation until and unless we can give education to women. So it means that both are the part of society. If we give education to women, they will bring prosperity, development. We can say that the Lab Ambedkar is the first institution where child gets education. It learns the basic manners. So, where there is the first institution for a child, and we close the doors of that institution by shutting their dead mother in the walls of home, this is not fair. So we have to focus that, give me educated mother, I will give you educated nation. Means today we have to open the doors of institution. We have to give education and we have to produce the educated mother. Then we can have an educated nation. Otherwise, there's no any way that we claim that we are an educated nation. Never ever. This is a great example of developed countries where women are on equal footing. They have the opportunities. Even from the different countries, only Pakistan got the chance of holding the post of prime ministership. There are the most modernizing important. Now, why from that women they are not coming? Means there are many posts in Pakistan they can get. But we have stopped that way and we have created many hurdles in their way. We have to just to get education. We have to provide them opportunities that today, tomorrow, they come. Women are the real architect of society. We ask that, Alhamdulillah, I am educated, we made claim that now I am graduated from university, I have a good job, but I want to make my home. That home can be the paradise, and we get married. At that time, we claim that we need such lady that she should be highly educated. Sometimes we claim even the bureaucrat. Sometimes we claim that we ask for the engineer, doctor, but are we ready to give education to our daughters or sisters? No. If you people, you are elder, if you will give education to your daughters, your sisters, tomorrow they will be the educated. And you can get the educated. So this is the reason. This is the same quotation that I explained it. Now we have to give look to the state of the woman in Pakistan. You are well familiar about the state of the woman which they have in Pakistan. If we compare the state of the woman with the rest of the world, you can easily understand this, what is the state of the woman in Pakistan and rest of the world. In Pakistan, there is a male-dominated society. We have learned one word that we have a right. We can do whatever like, but we did not give equal right to the woman. There is no any right woman to just speak and give viewpoint about his future, about his education to men. She never ever speak before the men. So why? We have to remove that hurdle for the women. We have, when we say that this society where men and women both are living, they have the equal rights, but we do not follow that quotation. So in Pakistan, there is a male dominant society where women, they are just bounded in the four walls. We have to break this chain.
Human rights are not protected in Pakistan.
There is a violation. Even there's a one girl, there's a one problem, that is the problem of the government, and those who are highly educated are living in society, they're having the jobs related with education, but they never ever established a school, college, but there is a college on large distance. Where that girl goes for education, on her way, she has to face so many problems. So this is the reason that there is no human rights for the women in Pakistan. Just we claim. We conducted many seminars that we will give equal rights to the girls, women, but really they are not. We are not giving them equal rights. So in Pakistan, the main purpose of this just conducting seminars and show you this image that we have to go back and we have to think. When you think, you can give good result. But if you stop the thinking, you cannot produce anything. So just, but still, there are many girls, they are deprived of getting timely education. Why they are deprived from these basic educations? Even they are going for jobs, they face so many problems.
Women movements are carefully observed by the people around them, and young women traveling especially alone is often taken negatively.
There is a class of 80 students. In their students, 70% are the men, only the 10% are the girls. They are getting education, means there is no equal ratio. That's why they are feeling the inferiority in our society. But if we have looked in our heart, in our mind, we show them great honor, that there is no discrimination. We are equal. Come and get education. Now if we are the 70, it means that we have gave message to our youngster that come and get education. Now it is your responsibility that from the large distance you came from village for getting education. It is your responsibility being a girl that you have to invite other girls, that I am like you. I have proved myself that I am getting education and I have a great honor. Even I am living in the male-dominated society, I have proved myself that I am not inferior to them. I am equal on their footing. Even in Pakistan, it is proved that you are the hard worker. You are getting first position. Even in this session, there are many young doctors. I can claim in this session, there are the two girls, they got the first and second position from Suhag board, and I hope so that in future they will get education. These are my students. So means they are getting education, you can do it. We have to realize that we are equal, there is no discrimination, just the time demands us that we have to give them time and we have to give them opportunities. Let's come. This stage is waiting for you, for the girls. Men, we are on the stage, but that place is empty. That is waiting for you. We have to show them and they will come, they will prove it. In Pakistan, there is a violation of human rights. Many women, they face food on the job. They are turned acid by the men. This is not the justice. They are equal. Why we are turning acid over there? If any critical situation, you can handle it. But they are the human like us. If any other men throw acid on me, what will be my condition? Just committing any crime, just you thinking about your result, the same result which are you gain to another, if you get same to you, what will be your future? So we have to never ever destroy the future of girls, ladies, because they are us. They are from us. We have to protect them. We have to give them equal rights that they can prove it. From them, they can be Alpha Khalid. She was the youngest girl. She does not belong to USA. She does not belong to UK. She belongs to Pakistan. So I am seeing that there are the many Alpha Khalids that they can be. But the main thing is that we have to give them opportunity. They will prove it. It is your responsibility that you have to prove it, that the talent, the secret of success is lying in your mind. Just it demands time. Trafficking, human trafficking, this is common in all over the world, but Pakistan is the third one dangerous country where human rights are violated. Girls, they are kidnapped. and they face so many problems. If we think they realize it, who kidnapped them? Why they kidnapped them? We have to think with it. If I kidnap another girl, that tomorrow my daughter will be kidnapped. I will never ever commit such activities will just destroy our society. We have to stop these activities. The next is child marriage. Afa Karim was the youngest girl. She proved herself that I have a brain, I am talented. Just give me time, I have to prove myself. But in Pakistan, many girls, they are forced to marry in their childhood. This is again the humanity. This is a social crime. We have to stop it. But one thing that is related with you people, you are the ones we can consider that here in Pakistan, your voice is suppressed. You are the voiceless. But you have to give voice, your voice. How you have to motivate them? You have to motivate your brother. You have to motivate your father. You have to motivate your sister. You have to motivate your father, your grandmother. Whatsoever, father, mother, I want to be the doctor. But I am not just want to be the doctor just as it is. But I have to be the specialist doctor. I want to serve the suffering people. So means it is your responsibility that I have a talent. You have to convey your parent that we want to do something. It is your duty that you have to do. Now okay. My child is educated. If I stop her education, I do not give her right that you may be doctor. It is not the justice. So in Pakistan, means she want to tell the parents, I want to be the doctor, I want to be the bureaucrat. You know that in Pakistan, in CSS, every year girls' quota goes empty. Are you aware about this? No. Every year in CSS, girls' quota go empty. Means seat goes empty. Why we are? Maybe we are aware, maybe we are not aware about that we have to prove it. If we want educated wife, but we are not in condition that we inform that in CSS, in BCS, your quota is empty and seats are empty. They are waiting for you. Who will come? From India? From UK? No. From our home, from our society. These girls have to be the commission officer. Seats are waiting for you. So you have to come, and this is against the what? Against the ethics. That you have a dare to talk to your father. So this is not the crime. This is the right that you should prove it that your daughter, she is the competent, and you have to realize her importance, that what she has brought in her mind before you. She want to discuss with you, so you have to be the proud of your daughter. Then my doctor want to be, my daughter want to be the doctor, want to be the engineer. So you should be the proud of the father. So you never ever discourage him. Then he was considered as the best administrator. When he was the headmaster in Nas Khalid school, he did the best for the people. Wherever he went over there, he worked on education. Even here, he has earned a great fame in Pakistan, in Khairpur. He never ever stopped giving education to the girls, but today we have proud of him. I expected from all of them that you have to be like this great man. He belongs to Khairpur. So means if today this is your responsibility, whatever you gain, whatever you are getting through education, for God's sake, that you have to be the practical man. You have to show the importance. But never ever just go in class and waste time. Never ever. Just you have to focus on your study. Then you can earn the good reputation. This is the biggest human crime.
happens in Pakistan unappealing. People, they kill their daughters, their wives, only for the sake of honor. I say that, what do you mean by honor? What is honor? Just killing the people, that is honor? No, it is your fault.
Give them.
These are the small cases. They are ill, they are raped in our society. There's a one thing that your law and order situation is not good. State, society is safe. That's why these people are there committing the crimes. So we have to give them honor. Violence against women committed with the motive of protecting them and regaining the honor of the parents, perpetrators, family or community. We say that if I kill my daughter or wife, then I will restore the honor. Never ever. You can earn the honor by giving them education. Let's suppose there is a one daughter. If father gives her education, he suffers his daughter like a son. The day will come when she was awarded with special prizes, even she will be able to get the job. In that stage, when she is called in stage for getting the prize, and she asks that, I will never ever get this award until and unless my father will come on stage, I will get award. Do you believe that? It is a great honor for their father, not killing his daughter. So this is the honor for you.
Educated people, they think about their honor, respect, or the illiterate people, they have a fear of their honor, respect. Sure. But I say they are educated people, they are afraid of. Let's suppose you are a doctor. There is an illiterate person. He comes in your office, he talks to you, he misbehaves with you. In that time, you will avoid, but you will not eager to fight with that person. So it means that educated people, they are afraid. Means they fulfill their responsibility, whatever their responsibility, they follow rules and regulations. Animals, they do not follow the rules and regulations. We are the civilization. We have to follow the rules and regulations. So this is the concern that we have to think in depth. Why women have no equal right in Pakistan? The biggest reason of that is low literacy. If you are educated, means you are fulfilling your responsibilities, whatever given to you. Whatever the responsibilities on your shoulder, you are fulfilling. But those who have no sense that I have to fulfill my responsibility, it means that in Pakistan, there is a low literacy rate. Now you can see that in Pakistan, there is a total literacy rate is 48%. On this stage, we claim that we are the educated people and we can bring, deliver, restore peace in Pakistan, never ever, because education is the main source through which we can bring peace, prosperity and development. So this is the reason, but in Pakistan, there is a low literacy, that's why women, they are murdered. They fear the honor killing. So this is the reason. Now come to the female's total literacy rate is about 48%. This is not good from the 100%. Your literacy rate is 48. How you can say that we want our rights? You have to just focus on your literacy rate. You have increased your literacy rate. Next is that males in Pakistan, there is one decade that we are not getting education, only there is a literacy rate is 70%. On this literacy rate, we can claim that we can give the equal rights to the women. No, we cannot bring development. We cannot
claim that we are the highly educated. We have to see that why, if I am educated, really, but I am not educated. I am just BA pass. I am just inter pass. So this is reason we cannot beat the world. Causes of gender discrimination means why we do not give the equal rights to women. These are the major causes: male dominating society, various social and religious beliefs, lack of strong protest by women. We consider that they are weak but physically they are powerless, so we just suppress their rights and they never ever go against the men. Because in Pakistan there is a male dominant society, but I say that it is not related with your heavy weight, that you should be the heavy and you fight for your rights, but you can fight through
your brain,
through your
education.
You have to get education, then you can fight for their power. There is peace and prosperity. Even you can claim that from their nation we can produce doctors, engineers, scientists. But if there is a low literacy rate, we cannot prove it. The biggest point that is related with the violation of human rights in Pakistan, you have an idea why in Pakistan we face this. I cannot do this one because no, there is no chance I cannot teach. Because there is a large number of people. Do you think that what can be to speak before the audience means there is a fear in my heart? So this is the reason that you have to wake up. Think that what you have to do it. Then you can you ask me that, Alhamdulillah, that all are the educated. What is the meaning of education? What is the awareness? So this is the reason that when you know the definition of education, education means knowledge. It is the definition of science. But education means awareness. Education is the reason that creates awareness in your mind among the audience. They wake up and do something great for yourself and for other people. So this is related with the education, that we have to get education and give education to our youngsters, because they are the future of tomorrow. They are the leader of tomorrow. If we do not give them education, we will never ever make progress. As earlier I explained it, there are the five most dangerous countries for women in the world. On the top of the list, there is Afghanistan, there is the violation of human rights, Congo, on second number, on third number Pakistan, on fourth number India, and on fifth number Somalia. It is not good for us that where our mothers or daughters or wives, they are living, they face so many problems. Really, it is a very shameful point for us that in Pakistan there is a violation of human rights. We have to wake up. Who is doing this one? From our side, from us, some people they are doing it. But we have to realize that we are the human. One human cannot go against or do any activities that he may or she. Solution for human empowerment. When we say that nature does not distinguish between male and female, does not create difference between male and female, then who we are? Why we are creating the differences? If from male side we show you that you are superior, you have to prove through dialogue that we are not superior. You can compete with us in the field of education, that we are superior to you. If we are superior to you, not, but
we are equal to you, so we deserve the equal respect. So this is the question from your side, you have to prove it yourself. Flow the dialogue. As I earlier discussed, now these are the solutions. If in Pakistan there is a discrimination, it's main reason that we are unable to give them education. So we have to promote education and we have to stop child marriage. Because it is our responsibility that we give them chance that they become doctor or engineer. So this related with them, we have to stop. This is the social crime. This is, we have to stop it. If we stop it, it means that we can educate the nation. There is a stage of everything. Child or the stage is not for the marriage. It is for getting education. We have to give education to our youngsters. And we have to stop it. Next, media is a power. Media can change the fate of the nation, can change the fate of the people. Media should play its positive role. If media plays its positive role, media should conduct or arrange such programs. In that programs, a good family should be shown. A girl who gets position in any board or any competition, media should promote it. So this is the responsibility of media. If any crime happens in any society, it is the responsibility of media. They must be committed. Next important point is that if we are conducting seminar, we are asking that there should be equality, women should be empowered. So what will be the result? If there is a gender equality, what will be the result? Why we are claiming, why we are fighting for the gender equality? Because we both are the part of the nature. They belong to us. We are not complete without the other gender. So this is the reason that we have to give them education, and where there is a gender equality, there is a peace and prosperity, and we promote democracy. Democracy, we can say that it is the best form of the government. Through democracy, we can elect the expert leaders, educated leaders. So gender equality is very important. The main session, the main purpose of this session was to just create the awareness and show the importance of women. They are not superior. They are equal. Even you can see my condition and I even can see your condition that we are sitting in this hall. Means there is one problem, load shedding. Why we are facing these problems might be, we can say that it is the result of nepotism or favoritism, or we can say that there was no marriage system or something else. So this is the reason. Let's come together. The main purpose of this day, we have to give education, to promote their education, girls' education. They are from us. There is no difference. Wherever we can send this message through media, through you people, that wherever you have a chance, for God's sake, promote the education for the girls. Never ever stop the hurdles in the way of girls' education. If they are educated, they give us education nations. So this is the reason we have strongly been in the Napoleon's quotation. And one important point is that you all are familiar about the condition of women in Arab. Before Islam, what was the condition of women? The Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, brought the women before men and giving them equal status. But today, we are decreasing their status. So if we are Muslim, we have to give equal rights to women. The main purpose, I will sum up my session.
We have to promote girls' education. It is their basic right as ours. Give them education and we have to promote their education, and even whatever, wherever there is no school, college, and we have to facilitate them, and through this message we support the girls' education. This is the best way that we have to show the equality. If we will not show the equality, we will face the so many problems. So for that reason, I have made one organization, Khairpur Talent Organization. If, let's suppose today I conducted a seminar because of this Khairpur Talent Organization. You are also the part of Khairpur Talent Organization. It is your talent that you are getting education. You gave your precious time that we are in the favor of giving education to the women. So this is the my slogan that let's come together and we have to educate the girls. This is the slogan of KTO. So even you can see my lectures on YouTube, Khalid, Suhag, our Khairpur Talent Organization. If you search on Facebook, you will find it. So I'm coming towards the question session. If you have any question regarding this, why we have conducted a seminar, why we have supported the women's education, why we want gender equality in Pakistan, if you have any question, you may ask. Question is very important. In Pakistan, there is no gender equality. This is the question. From your side, what can you give the answer? If you ask, so what we have the answer regarding this? Yes, any question regarding this one?
Of an empowered woman and how a woman can be empowered by maintaining their femininity. Means how a woman can be empowered by maintaining her femininity, and what are the qualities of an empowered woman?
Good. Means equally. We want to empower them because they are the weak. One important point is that in Pakistan there is one mindset. Feudalism. In Pakistan, feudal they are living, and only there is one mindset that no, never ever give the education to women. They should be in their home. If this is the mindset ideology, we have to break this chain. Even in our society, there are the many schools, but they are closed. And the one thing, we have changed this psychology of the people that know homes are not for the woman just where they have to stay 24 hours. Give them education. If you realize today that lack of mother is the first institution where child can grow and get education, learns the manners. If we just empower them by giving that woman education, she can be empowered, and tomorrow when she becomes mother, she can focus on the children, she can give education, she can take care of that child as much as you can, but you cannot do it. So this is the main reason I say that they are the architecture of the society. So I think that the empowerment of women is very essential. We have to change. Yes, another question.
Why are they right? Why are they voiceless? What are the reasons behind it?
They have the right to get education. Girls, they face the problem. Being a voice, they become the voiceless. So why they become voiceless? They say they only for the honor. How I hear to speak before the father? How can I speak before brother? So they have to think that if you speak to your father, for your sister, it is your right. This is not against. For God's sake, I will suggest you that change your ideology, change your mindset, that you have to wake up. Through wise, it is not that you are against your parents, but this is in your favor, and your parents, they will be happy. I give you the example of this one. Yesterday, I got a chance to meet with him personally.
I discussed some points with him. He said that I have one daughter. She is educated. Now she has a lecturership. She is lecturer in one government college. I asked him, sir, why did you provide an education that she got education? And he said that because you are strict, you are against the education of women, girls. So why you? Khalid, one day she came and even asked the permission, she knocked the door, Papa, may I come in? I said, yes. At that time I was giving book. She asked, Father, give me permission, I want to talk to you. If you have permission, then I will speak, otherwise I will go back. Father said that, yes, yes, brother. Papa, I have passed intermediate, now I want to go university, I want to join university. At that time, he was shocked, he was strict against their education. She asked that only you have to pass intermediate, after that you have to never ever go to university, because university atmosphere is not good for girls. He said that when he asked that question, I was shocked. Children, please, father, as you supported me from class 1 to intermediate, when I was small, I hold your finger and I discuss everything with you. For God's sake, please give me permission that I want to get education. There are the many girls who are unable to get education. They help father like you. If you support me that I will get education, tomorrow I will be the best doctor. And I promise that I will go in that deserted village and I will kill the woman who could not get education. The devil came that you will be proud of me. She went. On the next day, his son came in the room. He came just, excuse me, father, I want to discuss with you about my future. Father said, yes, please. Sir, Baba, I want to go to another university, Islamabad. Father said, why are you going to go to Islamabad? You can get a degree from Chandan. No, father, this is international university where I go and get my education. Father, he realized, he compared that now I have to check if there is the attitude of male and female. In that time, he said that, no, I have to support the education of women. And even if you have permission to serve my daughter, so you have to tell only you are the, no, you have a ship.
You cannot speak
before your father. But, Sarah, God saying, speak with a polite way. When you started with them, believe me, you gain the importance and you will be successful. Only please come up, remove your fear. Build up confidence in you. You have a great confidence. When you take the decision, you will never ever go back. But when we take decision, when we can go back. Another question? No question? Then why they are not giving us the quality education? Main thing is that they are unable, we have destroyed the atmosphere of merit. So this is the reason, if you have a talent, you can do it. Otherwise, if you are just educated by name, you cannot do it. So this is the system. Today, we just create awareness among you through this session that wake up, get education, as the international universities are offering the education to their youngsters. So our universities here to offer their education. Now, Alhamdulillah, Khairpur has become the hub of education here in Khairpur. There's a medical college, engineering university, and there are so many institutions that are open for you people. So come up and prove it that you are not educated and you are not uneducated. And you have to make educated an uneducated woman. You have to start classes for the adult.
हा सुठे कम के लिए तकलीफ होंगी है भाई पर असा हौसला बुलंद फेस कहे चंद दुनिया के तारीख में किताब में ये लफ्ज़ खुदा के वास्ते खत्म कर एक कामयाब मर्द के औरत पर गॉड से जो कोटेशन के यकीन ना अज इन कोटेशन के खत्म कर तारीख में मीडिया में बैठी है एक मर्द के कामयाब मर्द के औरत सक्सेसफुल there is a behind the successful person there is the head of woman for God's sake remove this time from the history page if you do not believe it but I strongly believe it let it is a correct gate behind the successful person there is the head of woman let's come together and educate the nation and we will be all educated thank you so much bilkul gadiya hai kahi bhi aap ke stage jo ko jugal chandus he gothan mein bhi vikas hai yakinan हर गोठ में मैं तो पहुंची सका तमाम हर केटी वाले पंज गोठ में वणो उन सा सुठे मानो सा उन सुठे नमूने सा गाला उन के बैकग्राउंड जो एजुकेशन हासिल कयो आखिर में सा जो है प्रोग्राम जो प्रोसेशन उन जे लाए खैर मेडिकल कॉलेज के स्टूडेंट के साइन अप संग के सा स्टे ते इन सेशन जे कोया फोटोग्राफी जे ला दावत दिना से अजी बेगा पर वन के पहुंचा प्लीज थैंक यू सो मच लास्ट पॉइंट जो पास आज सेशन रखा है वुमेन एंपावरमेंट तमाम पान सोचो तमाम मुखा पूछो त औरतन जी एफेक्ट चाहे या कुछ भी की आवाज नहीं मां के अंदर नॉलेज आए में कॉन्फिडेंस नहीं कहीं भी हिकी लेडी का पे सुन जन नजर सर आई कैन स्पीक ओके का जो सोच दे तो यही का असर चलता है पंज अंदर हिम्मत कर
For the sign of victory, please.